Sir, I will also come from March.
Okay, so good morning all the 8th standard children. Today we are going to start a new lesson, and the name of the lesson is A Newspaper is a Collection of Half Injustice. Okay, this is the 13th lesson which we are going to study, discuss. So you take off your book and you see who has written this beautiful poem. So this beautiful poem is written by Stephen Crane. So you see Stephen Crane, S-T-E-P-H-E-N-C-R-A-N-E, Stephen Crane. He was born in the year 1871 and he died in the year 1900. So you see how long he was having the life?
29 years.
29 years. So I can say that he died at a very young age, 29 years, very young age he died, okay. So second question is that from which country he was belonging? So he was American writer. Somebody has written something, message something, I have not seen. So again you can see, voice is audible?
Yes sir.
Okay.
Yes sir.
So a Stephen Crane, he has written this poem, A Newspaper is a Collection of Half Injustice. He died at the age of 29 only and he is an American writer. Okay. And then you see, who is best remembered for The Red Badge of Courage, a short novel of the American Civil War. Prolific throughout his short life, he also wrote Maggie, A Gift on the Stream, 1893, The Monster, 1899, the dramatic short story The Open Boat, 1898, which was based on Crane's own experience while stranded at sea for 30 hours after being shipwrecked. Means he died at the early age, but then also you can see his milestone of writing is enormous. Means many things he has written which people, readers, they have appreciated this, they like this. A highly innovative writer. So he is called innovative writer. So what we mean when we say innovative writer, the one who is bringing new ideas to the society, he is called innovative writer. The one who is coming with the new ideas is called innovative writer, new ideas. And then you see the next, his writing exerted a major influence on generation of American writers after him, notably amongst them Ernest Hemingway. So this writer was having a good influence on others writer, those who were going to become a writer. Okay, so generation effect he was having, and the follower, you can see Ernest Hemingway. The poem we just read is taken from his second collection of free verse, War is Kind and Other Lines, which deals with the effect of war. So this poem which we are reading, this is collection from War is Kind and Other Lines. Okay. So let us start this poem and let us understand what this poem is speaking all about. Go to the page number 103 and you see what is the function of a newspaper. The first question is, what is the function of newspaper? Why you read newspaper? Or what you think, why the people used to read newspaper? Maybe some are reading the newspaper to know what the government is doing in the country. Yes? Some are reading the newspaper to know what happened yesterday in the cricket match. Yes? Some are reading only sports page. Some are reading only the government action plan Okay, some are reading what happened around their town, city, village, what happened, which incident happened, right? Some are reading the newspaper to know the prices of so many things like gold, silver and so many other things. Some are reading the newspaper to get the information, okay? About any exam, about any result. So people are reading newspaper for different purpose. Maybe some are reading newspaper for entertainment. They want to know all the details about the film star, okay, about the Hollywood, Bollywood films. So they are reading the newspaper. So the purpose of a newspaper is different, and the different readers, they used to read the newspaper according to their wish and choice. Now let us discuss about this. The newspaper is informing, educating also, activating also, entertaining also, and merchandise also. Okay, merchandise means, for example, any product is there and that product is endorsed in the newspaper. Like if you will buy this car, you will get 10% discount now only, right? So you are becoming interested and you are going to buy the car, right? So that is called merchandise. Give one example of each of these functions. So in this paragraph, you have to write example of each of the function. That how the newspaper is informing, how the newspaper is educating, how the newspaper is activating the people, entertaining and merchandise. I hope you all can do this. Okay. Question number 2. Do you think at times the media can be unfair? So this question is little bit tricky question, because this question is asking from you to say that do you think media can be unfair at times? Give example. Means this question want to know your point of view, that do you think that media can show some propaganda, or the media can show only one side of the thing and not the other side? Do you think this is possible? So before writing this answer, I will give you some suggestion. What is my suggestion? That don't be negative in your answer. Don't write anything which is affecting your personality, that you are a pessimist. Pessimist means a person who think negative, that only negative is happening all around. Okay, all the bad people are there everywhere. Okay, no one is good, no one is perfect. We don't want this type of ideology. We want the ideology of optimist. Okay, you see, to run a family, okay, how many members are there who are working? Maybe the father is working for the income, mother is caring all the food and all the things, children are going and studying and playing, right? Means to run a house, how many members are involved? Like that only children. To run a government also, so many people are working. To run the media also, so many people are working day and night. Okay, but yes, it is true, sometimes the media can be unfair. Okay, sometimes media can be unfair, but not always. And how the media can be unfair? When the data they have collected, maybe that data is not authentic. Maybe the resource from where they are getting the news, that is not authentic. Then there is high chance that the fake news can also circulate on the media, or one side or one point of view we can see. But we should understand that never ever any media spokesperson used to intentionally do these things. Okay, are you able to understand? Okay. So the writer is beautifully remarking here and saying that a newspaper is a collection. he was caught of stealing. Understood? He was doing stealing and he was caught, school going boy. So he went to the children's jail, right? This is coming in the newspaper. But maybe this is also possible that after going to the jail and trial, he is going to the court, and in the court it is proved. It is proved that the child is innocent. But this news is not coming in the newspaper, that the child who was arrested 1 week ago, that child was proven innocent. So writer is explaining here that newspaper is a collection of half injustice, half truth we are knowing. Okay, never ever the newspaper is a complete source of information. So every day they used to publish it. Okay, you think why they are publishing news every day? Because it is not complete source of information, and every day something is happening, some more resource they are getting, so they are writing in the newspaper. I will recommend all the children that after studying your 12th standard, you can start reading newspaper for 10 minutes, 15 minutes. Okay, that will create awareness what is happening around the society and the world. Okay, you can see so many statements made by the different world leader, and you can come to know that where we all are heading. Okay, means where we all are going. But the same time, I will suggest not to read too much of the newspaper before 12th standard, because already you are having your own syllabus, your own book, your own examination. Okay, so you should care there. But if you are good in managing the time, and if you think that sir, I can focus on my studies also, and 10 to 15 minutes I can read the newspaper also, then you are very good. Okay, so try to read the English newspaper, because I am English teacher and you are studying in English medium school. So this is my suggestion. In future ever, if you are going to get the habit of reading the newspaper, try to read the English newspaper. Now read this poem about newspaper, and you see a newspaper is a collection of half injustice which bound by bias from mile to mile. So generally, who used to sell the newspaper? Okay, so newspaper, this is also a very good turnover. Okay, means a good business they all are doing in a newspaper children, in mass media. But finally, the one who is delivering the newspaper, you will see that they used to be nearly poor. Yes or no? Okay, the chief reader who is writing the newspaper, he is not coming and selling the newspaper. No, that give me 5 rupees and take this paper, give me 12 rupees and take this paper. No. Generally, the young children of 10 to 14 years age and above, they used to sell the newspaper. Okay, so here also we can see one shot of child labor. Okay, for 1 hour in the morning only, but the child is doing some work, no? Okay, 10 to 14, 15 years above you can see. Sometimes you can see men are also doing this, okay? And it is good that men are doing. So you can see which bold by boys from mile to mile. So boys are shouting, newspaper, newspaper. And maybe they are shouting some headings also, okay? And they are saying, they are selling the newspaper, right? So when I was preparing for my college, so that day one child was coming, he was 13-14 year old, and I was living on the second story. Okay, so he said me that you don't need to come down to take the newspaper, you say your room, which room is there, on that balcony every day I will throw the newspaper. I said that this much good target, how you can have? Second story building and that particular balcony, how you will throw exactly there only? It can go some other place also. He said that you don't worry, this is my issue. And every day he was throwing the newspaper at the right place. Can you believe these children? Means that much practice I think they have got, that where the newspaper they have to throw, so to the real customer it will reach. Right? So like this they used to come inform in the morning one voice you can hear, maybe on the bicycle they are coming and they are saying paper, paper, right? And their voice used to be good. And one more person is coming to collect the newspaper, means old newspaper, if you are having a good collection, they will come to buy that old newspaper from you, and in that place they will give you some money also, right? Some rupees they will give. So the difference you can see is in their language. The one who is selling the current newspaper, his voice will be very much polite. He will say politely, paper, paper. And the one who is coming to buy the old newspaper, rag picker, his voice will be harsh, loud. Okay? Can you recall now? Online children also, can you recall now? So this is the way to find out that he has come to sell the newspaper or to buy the newspaper. He is a newspaper boy or a rag picker. Spread is curious opinion. And the newspaper boy is spreading this curious opinion. Curious opinion means, see, in the book the meaning is given strange, but curious means the one who is very excited to know something. For example, I am very curious to know the medicine of coronavirus. Okay? Curious means very excited to know. So it spreads its curious opinion. Okay. So all others are also excited to know that what you are speaking. So finally they have to buy the newspaper, and they will buy the newspaper, they will read that what the news is there. Now third line. Okay. Generally how in the newspaper the heading used to be. If you will see the heading of the newspaper, that will attract you to read the whole story, whole paragraph, right? If you will see the newspaper, okay? For example, one news was there about a footballer, famous footballer, right? Surgery and now he cannot walk, now he cannot play. Okay, like this the heading was. So I thought, what is this? I started reading the whole paragraph and I came to know that all these things are going for a short video, means in a documentary, means this is not true. For example, something they will write which will make the readers to read the whole inside the story, and inside the story you will find that nothing is like that what the heading suggests. Okay, so they used to make the very catchy headings. To a million merciful and sneering men, and his opinion is to the million of merciful and sneering men. So two words here he is using. Merciful means the one who is kind. Sneering means the one who is searching for kindness. Okay? So in this world, writer is saying that million of people are there. One is kind and one is searching for kindness. He is not saying that one is kind and one is cruel. He is saying that one is kind and one is searching for kindness. Okay, Sakshi, stand up and read. so many advertisements also in the newspaper you can see, right? And what the incident are happening around the city, the town, that also you can see. Okay. So newspaper used to update the person that what things are going around. And what is parallel to the newspaper? Parallel to the newspaper is the television news channel. So this television news channel, they used to inform by words sitting in the studio. Okay. And what is the difference between both? See, the difference between both is newspaper means you have to read, you have to think, you have to analyze. But the news channel, you see, they are working for you. They are reading, they are thinking, they are analyzing, and the final conclusion they are informing to you. So it is easy to watch the news channel, but it is important to read the newspaper, because the newspaper is providing your, it is enhancing your thinking skill. How much you can think means I am saying you, now you all will understand what I want to say. Imagine in this class three children are sitting, right? And I am giving three newspaper to them, means same newspaper of same date to all the three. And I am asking them to read the newspaper and say your point of view on that particular news. This is my guarantee that all the three students will say the different opinion by reading the same article in the newspaper, right? But the news channel, what they used to do, if I will ask you all three to sit in a room and I will start a news channel on any topic, and if I will switch off the television and then I will ask what you have understood from this news, then all the three will say the same answer. Are you understanding? This is the difference between the newspaper and news channel. Newspaper leaves everything on you, that you think, you analyze, you decide your point of view. But news channel is working for you, all the hard work they are doing, like they are reading, they are analyzing, and finally the conclusion they are bringing in front of you, so that the conclusion you can know. Online children, are you able to listen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so online children, three and here, six children are there. So study nicely. And one more thing I want to say to all the 8th standard children, weekly assignment you have to submit till 21st of February. But in the assignment, the date is given 28th of February. So don't think that 28th of February you have to submit. You try to submit it as soon as possible.